Hello and welcome to SSB Crack Exams. This is Girish and in this session we will solve the MCQs based on daily current affairs. Today is 7th of February and these MCQs will be helpful for your AFCAT, NDA, CDS, CAPF, Territorial Army and various other defense examinations. Before we begin, I would like you to inform that we SSB Crack Exams, being India's largest defense examination preparation portal, have launched courses for AFCAT, CDS, NDA, CDS-OTA, Territorial Army, INET, Indian Air Force Airmen Group X, Group Y, and various other defense and paramilitary examinations. You can visit our website, ssbcrackexams.com, and know more about our courses. You can follow us on Instagram, you can follow us on YouTube. You can also download our app, SSB Crack Exams, in the Google Play Store and know more about the defense examinations and the defense examination preparation. You also have an introductory offer wherein which by using the code WARRIOR10, you will get flat 10% off on all the courses. Let's get started. The first question is, who will head the Ram Janmabhoomi Tirth Kshetra Trust? Option A, Rajiv Dhawan. Option B, Pandit Ravi Shankar. Option C, K. Parasaran, and option D, Soli Sorabji. You have to choose the correct answer. And the correct answer is C, K. Parasaran. K. Parasaran is a former Attorney General and a senior Supreme Court advocate. Here is his image. And K. Parasaran is the one who fought for the Ram Janmabhoomi by representing all the parties in the Supreme Court in the famous Ayodhya case. Okay. We know recently Supreme Court gave a historic verdict with regarding to the Ayodhya land dispute between the Hindus and the Muslims. Okay, so what the Supreme Court said is a temple will be built and this temple will be built and will be taken care of by a trust. And recently Prime Minister Narendra Modi in the parliament in Lok Sabha has announced the formation of this trust, the Ram Janmabhoomi Tirth Kshetra Trust. And this trust will now be headed by K. Parasaran. Okay. So this trust will take care of all the construction activity of the temple and all. Okay. The next question is, which of the following definitions are incorrect? First statement, basis points, increase in interest rate in percentage terms. The second statement, repo rate, the rate at which commercial banks borrow from RBI by selling their securities or financial assets to the RBI for a long period of time. Third statement is about the reverse repo rate, the rate of interest at which the central bank borrows funds from commercial banks for a short duration. The fourth statement is about the cash reserve ratio, the minimum percentage of cash deposits that banks must keep with itself to avoid the liquidity issues. We have to choose the incorrect statements. And the correct answer is option C, 2 and 4. If you see the second statement, the repo rate is the rate at which commercial statement borrows from RBI by selling their securities or financial assets to the RBI for long period of time. This is the incorrect statement because the repo rate and the reverse repo rate are the rates which are decided for the short-term borrowings. For the short-term borrowings and not the long-term borrowings. So this second statement is wrong. Now if you see the fourth statement, it is talking about cash reserve ratio, which is the minimum percentage of cash deposits that bank must keep with itself to avoid the liquidity issues. This is the wrong statement because the cash reserve ratio is the amount of cash deposits that the bank must keep with the RBI. It's not with itself, it's with the RBI. The amount of deposits that it has to hold with itself is called the SLR or statutory liquidity ratio. Okay, so this statement is also wrong. The reverse repo rate, as I said, it is talking about the short duration where the reverse repo, the central bank is borrowing money from the market, that is the banks. So this is the correct statement. And the first statement is about the basis points, increase in interest rates in percentage terms. This is also right. Okay, so option C is the correct answer because statement 2 and 4 are wrong. Now, why I ask this question is, recently, the RBI Monetary Policy Committee has announced its bi-monthly policy and it has kept the repo rate and the reverse repo rate unchanged. The repo rate is kept at 5.15%, the reverse repo rate is kept at 4.9%, and the MSF or marginal standing facility is kept at 5.4%. What is reverse repo rate? What is repo rate? what are marginal standing facility. We have covered all of this in our lectures. You can go through that once again if you have any doubts. Okay. The next question is, Kia Motors has set up its first plant in India in option A, Andhra Pradesh, option B, Tamil Nadu, option C, Karnataka, and option D, Maharashtra. We have to choose the correct answer. And the correct answer is A, Andhra Pradesh. Kia Motors has set up its first plant in India in Anantapur district in Andhra Pradesh. Okay, this is the first time Kia has set up a plant in India, and it has launched its car also, which is Kia Seltos. Okay. The next question is, the fourth question, Vivad Se Vishwas scheme is related to option A, indirect taxes, option B, commercial company disputes, option C, direct taxes, and option D, insolvency process. We have to choose the correct answer. And the correct answer is C, direct taxes. Option C is the correct answer. Finance Minister Srimati Nirmala Sitharaman, in her budget speech, has announced this scheme, Vivad Se Vishwas. We know that there are large number of cases that are pending before the courts regarding taxes. So Finance Minister has announced this scheme so that the tax litigations can be reduced. There are a lot of cases that are pending, and the Finance Minister has offered this scheme as a complete waiver on interest and penalty that a person has to pay to the government. Okay, and this has to be done by March 31st. This scheme aims to benefit those whose tax demands are locked in disputes in multiple forums. Okay. The next question is, the fifth question, the aim of Atal Bhujal Yojana is A, managing drinking water, B, providing water to rural regions, C, managing groundwater, D, management of urban water bodies. We have to choose the correct statement, and the correct statement is C, managing groundwater. The government has approved 6,000 crores for Atal Bhujal Yojana, Atal Jal. We know the Narendra Modi government, when it formed for the second time in 2019, has brought in this new ministry, the Jal Shakti Ministry. The Jal Shakti Ministry. So under this ministry, the scheme comes. And this scheme aims to manage the groundwater in a best possible manner. Because we know these days, what is happening is the groundwater level is decreasing very rapidly. So we have to make sure that the groundwater is protected, and such a scheme will be very helpful. This scheme is for the sustainable management of the groundwater, as we discussed, with a community participation in water stressed blocks of Gujarat, Haryana, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, and Uttar Pradesh. This scheme is being implemented during the 2020-21 to 2024-25 with the financial assistance from the World Bank, with a sharing pattern of 50-50 between Government of India and the World Bank. This scheme has two components, institutional strengthening and capacity building component, and incentive component with outlays of 1400 crores of 4600 crore respectively. Okay, so just make sure you know these important points, like from which ministry it is, which ministry is implementing this scheme, what are the states, I'll write here just to make a note on this, which ministry, what are the states wherein which this is implemented, and with which bank we are collaborating for this. Okay, just make sure you remember all these important things. The next question is, High Energy Materials Research Laboratory, HEMRL of DRDO, has signed technology development contract with which country? Option A, Israel. Option B, Russia. Option C, Sweden. And option D, United States of America, USA. We have to choose the correct answer. And the correct answer is option B, Russia. The High Energy Material Research Laboratory is the DRDO's laboratory working in the development of spectrum of high energy materials required for missiles, rockets, and guns. During the Defense Expo 2020, HEMRL Pune signed technology development contract with Rosoboron Export of Russia, okay, for the development of advanced pyrotechnic ignition systems. So Russia is the correct answer. The next question is, India's biggest rural technical festival, Antaprajna 2020, started in A, Tamil Nadu, B, Karnataka, C, Andhra Pradesh, and D, Telangana. The correct answer is option D, Telangana. India's biggest rural technical festival, Antaprajna 2020 started in the state of Telangana. Okay, remember this, Antaprajna 2020 in Telangana. The next question is, 8th question, RBI insurance covers on bank deposits has been increased from 1 lakh to option A 3 lakhs, option B 2 lakhs, option C 1 lakh and option D 5 lakhs. You have to choose the correct statement and the correct answer is option D 5 lakhs. The insurance cover on the bank deposits has been increased from 1 lakh to 5 lakh by the RBI. Okay, this is done with a view to protect and provide greater measure of protection to all the depositors and the depositors trust on the banking system. The trust on the banking system will increase. Okay, so that's why the scheme is introduced, or you can say that's why the minimum insurance has been increased. The 9th question is, the 22nd edition of India International Seafood Show IISS to be held at A Kochi, B Chennai, C Coimbatore and D Visakhapatnam. We have to choose the correct answer and the correct answer is A Kochi. The 22nd edition of the India International Seafood Show to be held at Kochi. Okay, the next question and the last question for the day, who was recently appointed as the president of Paralympic Committee of India? Option A Deepa Malik, option B Vinesh Singh, option C KPS Gill and option D Sushil Kumar. We have to choose the correct answer and the correct answer is option A Deepa Malik. So Deepa Malik was recently appointed as the president of Paralympic Committee of India. Deepa Malik has won silver medal in the Rio Olympics, not the normal Olympics, in the Rio Paralympic Games. This Deepa Malik has won the silver medal. She was elected as the president of Paralympic Committee. Okay, so that's it for this lecture. I'll see you again. Till then, stay tuned to SSB Crack Exams. Jai Hind.